Alright guys, I hope you guys are doing well because people have been complaining saying I'm not posting well. So I'm going to make a video about a topic which I believe in Indian biking is very much not shown about. So the thing is, when I went for my first ride, I had a lot of difficulties in understanding what people are doing with their hands crazily and things people were saying and things people were implying, because you are really nervous, and you are nervous on top of that, you're going to affect another 10 people behind you, and people in front are going too fast. There are so many stuff that come up. So I thought of making these, you know, tiny tips that would probably help a individual who is going for his first bike ride, because I personally had no one to tell me these things and I had to learn it the hard way. So anyway, around without any further ado, let's get started today. Alright, so we are into the video, and this is the number one thing which I want to tell you guys if you're going for a ride. It is to have your mirror attached on your bloody bike. I think that's a very simple advice. All you need to do is fix your mirrors before you go for a group ride. Knowing what is behind you can really help you the decision when you're going forward. I know that sounds really cool, but trust me, having your mirror plays a very important role when you're on the road. It really helps you identify possible people that are going to overtake you. Know if someone is behind you so that you can make a better move, you know, perhaps when you're overtaking someone in front of you. At the same time, it gives you awareness, a sense of security that you are. There are times when you lose contact with the person in front and that could lead you getting anxious, but having a cross check on your mirror without turning your head could also be a very, very useful thing you could do by just, you know, having your mirror. I know some people are very against this, and I personally haven't let anyone come for a group ride if they don't have a mirror. At least have a bar end mirror, get an idea of what is behind you. If you have a camera on your helmet that shows you in your visor what you're doing, I am more than happy even if you don't have mirrors. So you get the point, have your bloody mirrors on your bloody bike. So the biggest mistake I see people doing is before they go for a group ride, they just randomly let people join in. I do not recommend that. Please make sure that you have a list of riders that you're going with, their contact details, their blood group before you start a ride. You wouldn't know what could go wrong. I mean, there are times when I had random people join in, I made sure like sign a consent form that they are responsible for their own stuff that happens on road. So it is necessary that you have a list of riders, a tally of how many people are coming in, probably a pep talk to make sure that who is the, you know, lead and who is the person who is going to be the tail, who is going to check on people and things like that, and probably have a, you know, group for just having a WhatsApp group sake to share the pictures later on or communicate if necessary. So these are things which I found necessary. This is just a small little tip for, you know, before you start the ride, because that's how I'm going to go. I'm going to go from the beginning to the end of the ride. So that's tip number two for ensuring that you have a proper form and channel of communication with your riders. Tip number three is actually a bit tricky. It involves a little bit of common sense, a little bit of understanding how things work in a biking group. So basically, you want the person who is well versed with directions to be in the front. Right behind that, you want people who have lower CC, non-ABS bikes to follow the leader. And all the higher CC bikes keep behind the lower CC bikes, because there are cases where higher CC bikes don't realize that they have so much power and they accelerate to an extent where the lower CC bike cannot catch up. I know this sounds like a very drag, I mean the whole point of riding is to go fast, but no. When you're riding maturely, it's about keeping everyone in mind and keeping them safe. It's about you enjoying the ride and reaching the destination without having any problems. So I really recommend having a close eye on who is riding where and how are they doing. So the tail is going to be a person who has comparatively the most highest powerful bike, or probably a leader or an elder person who knows how to ride and has been riding for a long time. People who are new to riding should also be in the front, so that people who are behind get an eye of everything. Now, the formation can be very much numbered if possible. 1, 2, how many other numbers are to be allotted to the people. You can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then you can say a person is the lead and the other person is the tail. You can have a passerby or a person who continuously overtakes from all the way back to the front to ensure that everyone is doing well and good. Alright, the next thing which I really want to focus on is knowing your hand signs. Just remember, you are not riding alone. You are riding with people who are looking at you for knowing whether there is a danger ahead, whether it's right to go this way, whether it's good enough to go this fast. So you need to be very good with communications. It's not just about you. Don't be selfish over here, okay? You need to focus on how you are going to communicate with people who are behind you. This is essential. There is a guide that I put in the description of all the things I mentioned and some more extra stuff. If you're really into hand signs, I'll make sure there is a video linked in the description too, because I cannot show that literally right now, but I will focus on this feature because I have noticed a lot of changes. So what I recommend is, if you follow the previous point, it would be really good if you have hand signs discussed in the meeting beforehand, because I have noticed several times people having different types of hand signs and they misinterpret that and they end up doing something else. So it's kind of awkward to like clarify these things. So somewhat admit the fact that you're not aware of it properly to your fellow riders and get sure and updated about what is the right way to do this. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna say is being prepared. So at least one rider in each group should have a first aid kit and a full toolkit, and all riders should carry a cell phone. This is very important because I personally felt like having a cell phone that is paired up and connected to your helmet really helps you attend calls and communicate with people in case you're being missed out, so that each second you're wasting waiting on the road does not become kilometers later on the road. And other than that, so the group is prepared for any other problem they might encounter. These kind of problems could possibly leading to a puncture or maybe low fuel, so this is a very good way to keep in touch. So I recommend someone having a little bit of toolkit, perhaps a screwdriver, some zip ties. These are things which I usually carry around, a torch. These things really help depending on what time of the day you are going. If it's a dark or a night ride, high visibility clothing, stuff like that, spare gloves. You don't know who's gonna come up without a glove. So yeah, your responsibility is to keep every rider safe and make sure they reach the destination in one piece. Yeah, alongside with their bike. Yeah, obviously, that's pretty obvious. If you have a lot of gears, start wearing them before the others say go, because most of the time I have a shit ton of stuff to put on and this leads to me taking more time and making the whole group wait. So think about every decision you do. It affects at least two other people. So this means everything you carry, to the things you do, to the things you show off with, has to be accountable for being sensible and not, you know, putting a weight on someone else. So think about this. And if you ever feel like you're gonna take time to do something, inform your leader. I want a break, my gloves are coming loose. I want a break, or can you stop on the side? My buckle's coming off my helmet. Something or the other, communicate. If you wanna clean your visor, communicate. If you wanna pee, communicate. If you wanna break up with your ex, communicate. Also, a few things to keep in mind. These are like bonus stuff which I wanted to spit out randomly on a free speech manner. Is like, you come with your tank full, so you don't become a hazard to other people saying, hey, I want to fill my tank. Fill up your tires, come with gear, fill up your water bottle, whatever it is, be prepared in every aspect. If you have a pillion, keep in mind about this also, gear them equally, the same way you would gear up, because if an accident occurs, both of you are treated in the same way. So gear up properly. I mean, you could probably exclude the pillion from wearing gloves. I do not recommend it, but yes, you can, but a full face helmet is compulsory.
So you have made it to the end of the video. I thank you for that. And if you like the content which I have made right now, please do leave a like. Else you can comment, which really helps the video get to other people because you are talking about the video. So even if you don't subscribe, just comment at least to what you felt. If I'm a horrible person, let me know in the comments. Other than that, I hope you have some tips to share with other people. So do leave that also in the comments. Other than that, be safe, take care, and do not go out because Corona is gonna get you. I still don't have an outro, so I'm just gonna casually, slowly turn off the recording. Alright? Yeah.
Are you stupid or something?